The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Bravery and self-sacrifice seem to carry no colors, no flags, no religious beliefs or nationality. They exist in certain men and women regardless of peace or war. Their exploits are not confined to any date or era. The mystery of their devotion, whether it be to a cause or saving a life, is worth retelling anytime. Whitfield, dear. Where? Yes, got that. Crash landed. You got him out of the plane. How is he? Is he conscious? Yes, we'll drive right down. You did the right thing. We're on our way. Nurse, Moltoff crash landed near Dover.
How is he?
It'll be a miracle if he lives. Mystery drama entitled Rescue, based on actual wartime incidents, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by G. Frederick Lewis and stars Louis Turenne. I shall return shortly with Act One. Believe it. Frenchmen thought they were living in a nightmare. But in June of 1940, France agreed to an armistice with Germany, and Hitler's troops marched through Paris. However, there were many who continued fighting their own war, even those who were considered unfit for combat, like Pierre Montand, who had one leg, one crutch, and one idea: to get out of Paris and join the Royal Air Force in England.
Is it?
Pierre, let me come in.
Hurry.
The Germans are at the north gate of the city.
Porte de la Chapelle.
Whoever wishes to leave Paris has until midnight to go. After that, all gates around Paris will be locked.
To go? Which way?
South, of course.
Are you going?
What good am I here? Tomorrow the Germans will march along the Champs-Élysées. And every Frenchman who remains in Paris is a prisoner. Yvonne, I wish you would think seriously about leaving Paris now. Who knows how long the Germans will be here? There is no future for a son or daughter of France under the whip.
Pierre, how can I? My father and my mother, I'm all they have. How could they run this little hotel without me?
I hope you'll change your mind. I'm going out now to buy some food to take with me.
With one leg, how quickly do you think you can travel?
So it will take me twice as long. That means if I wish to join the Air Force of Britain, I will have to rest less and walk more.
How will you cross the English Channel?
With my wings. That is the one advantage of having only one leg. No one suspects you are a pilot. So when I walk into an aerodrome, people think it's just an idle curiosity. They don't know there isn't a French or German plane I cannot lift into the air in 2 minutes. Yvonne, I'm going to buy an extra bottle of wine. And when I come back with my provisions, you and I are going to share a farewell glass.
Oh, please, I'm sorry.
But look what you have done, you idiot, running into.
I'm sorry.
Well, at least I saved the wine. But look at the bread and all my groceries all over the street.
Please, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to run into a cripple.
I'm not a cripple. I have lost a leg. But aren't you going to help me pick up my food from the street?
I can't. I'm running. Gestapo are after me.
Gestapo here?
Please, help me.
The door, it's where I live.
Stand inside while I pick up my food.
You!
What?
Have you seen a short man with a black hat and a long black overcoat?
What are you talking about? Look at this. Some child on a bicycle who doesn't care where he's going. And poof, all my food is on the street.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, yes. Did you hear what I said?
I am with the Gestapo.
You are in Paris already? I thought the Nazis aren't entering Paris until tomorrow morning. Well, don't stand there. Help a man.
Hold still then, and I'll put everything in your arms. Yes.
You? End of the hall is my room. Go ahead of me. The door is open.
Right.
Hide in the clothes closet.
Pierre, what was all that noise outside?
Oh, some idiot ran into me and everything I was carrying scattered all over. But I saved the bottle.
Ah, I'll miss you. Shall we open it now?
No. I want to pack my things. I want to leave in an hour.
Let me help you.
No. Here, you keep the bottle. When I am done, I'll come back to your front room and we will pull the cork.
Oh, someone's at the front door again. All I do all day is go to the door and say, no vacancies.
I was afraid he would follow me. It's my friend from the Gestapo, Yvonne. Yvonne, do me a big favor. If he's looking for someone, delay him as long as you can. He will want to know which is my room. Don't tell him for at least 5 minutes.
Open arm, Gestapo!
One moment. I'm coming.
Here. You come out of the closet.
I heard somebody at the front door. He's come after me.
Yes. My landlady will hold him off in the front room. We have a few minutes.
I'm as good as dead.
Are you Jewish?
Yes.
Well, then I'm as good as dead, too, for hiding you.
It's good wine, isn't it?
Excellent. Mademoiselle, I must search your house.
Of course you must, but another glass first. After all, if you Germans are coming to Paris to live, I want to show you how hospitable we are.
I'll come back later. Who else lives on this floor?
You, get on the bed.
No,
not under the bed. On it.
All right.
You're small. Uh-huh. Curl yourself up at the foot.
All right, yeah.
That's it. Now I will pile these blankets on top of you. All right. I'm going to sit in this chair. Put my foot on the bed and I'll be reading.
All right.
Don't move.
I won't.
Fine.
You look like a pile of blankets on a bed that's been slept in. Yes, hello, who is it?
Yes, there's a gentleman here who's looking for someone.
Well, there's nobody in here but me, even. But you may come in if you wish.
You see, Herr Jaeger, nobody but Pierre in here. Pierre, this is Herr Jaeger of the German State Police.
Oh, we have met. He was kind enough to help me with my groceries.
I don't know who you're looking for. But I can assure you, no stranger gets by my door.
Well, all right. Just make sure they don't, or you are in much trouble.
What about that second glass of wine before you leave?
No, Duncan. Nein, I'd better have not any more. If my commandant smells good French wine on my breath, he will call me a traitor. Well, good night.
You can come out of those blankets now.
He won't come back. My name is Pierre Monton.
And mine is Leon von Stuver.
What do we do with you, Leon von Stuver?
Yes.
I have just 4 hours left to get out of Paris. All the gates will be locked at midnight. In the morning, the gendarmerie will hand over the keys to the Nazis. I am not staying for the occupation.
Well, where are you going?
To Britain.
Can I go with you?
Can I go with you, he asks. It's not enough that I have only one leg to escape with. The two legs you have are Jewish. That's to be thought of.
Well, of course, you're right. You've done enough for me. Is there a back door or a way over the roof?
Van Stuver, stay where you are. Don't be brave and stupid. Let's save your life.
Oh, I agree to that. But I don't wish to endanger yours.
Leon, this can be a long war. Are you going to spend it running from house to house?
You have a better idea?
My way of leaving France is better than anyone's.
You use the roads?
No.
A boat on the Seine?
Not bad, but no.
The train?
No.
Well, what do you do? Fly?
Exactly.
But you can fly an airplane?
That's how I lost my leg. I parachuted into a tree.
You... You were in the French Air Force?
No, no, no. A flying instructor. I teach flying.
Yes, it's me, Yvonne. He's gone.
He was suspicious.
Even of me. And I offered him some more wine.
Have you thought it over? I tell you, your mother and father will be all right. Nothing will happen here to old people. Come with us.
I've decided to stay.
May the Lord end this horrible war soon, so that I can return to Paris.
I would like to see you again, too. Au revoir.
Fantastic. The way you go to a garage and find this American Jeep and start it going with a screwdriver.
I can start a Messerschmitt with a hairpin.
How much further to where we're going?
The Germans have taken Alleville-Air-Dôme. It's 30 kilometers. Mm. We should be there before dawn.
I'm running from the Germans and you're taking me to them?
If we arrive early enough, I shall find us a plane and off we go. If not, I shall wait until night, and then try again.
You know this airdrome?
I thought flying here.
I hear airplanes.
Bomber. They're headed this way.
What does that mean?
They're either German Stukas returning from a raid over England, or British Lancaster.
Where are you driving the Jeep? Into a ditch. Get up. Crawl to that boulder lying across the ditch and get under it.
The Jeep was not hit. But the front wheels are axle deep in mud. We shall start the motor and then try to free the wheels. Leon, can you see that screwdriver I used?
Found it. Right on the floor.
Thank you. Yeah. Place one end into here, in this wire there. And across.
Yes. Okay, there.
Clutch, neutral. Good.
Now,
all we have to do is rock it back and forth to get it free from the mud. Hand me my crutch.
Huh?
It's on your side, under the seat.
What do you want me to do?
Stand where you are and push backwards, as I tell you. Ready?
No, not yet.
Are you? Yes, I'm behind the wheel.
Well, good, I'm ready.
One. Push. Sorry. Hold it. I'm going to put it in reverse. We'll do better there. Ready?
Yes, ready. Push! Again! Push! All right! Once more! We're almost free!
Ready?
Push!
Back on the road again!
We're free!
That's great!
Yeah, climb in, Leon.
If we make it to Alleville-Air-Dôme before another bomber run, we've a chance of finding a plane.
Are those British who are bombing our bill just now?
When we get to England, we'll scold them.
Are you sure we'll find a plane?
There hasn't been a French, British, or German plane I haven't been able to get off the ground with a nail file.
But after you start the plane, how do you fly it with only 1 foot?
By those? 1 foot and 1 crutch. It's a special talent.
An interesting brand of man, this Pierre Montand. Disabled, yet driven to help his crippled country by joining the Allies. And willing to risk his own safety for a man he considers in worse danger than he. I shall bring you more of Pierre Montand's twistings and turnings to escape fate when I return shortly with Act Two. Germans are marching into Paris. The hunt has already spread across France to find those who are Jews. Pierre Montand, with crutch and one leg, is helping Leon van Stuve, a Dutchman, also escaped the Gestapo. The two men are inside what remains of the hangar of Hollaville, searching through the ruins for a plane that is airworthy.
Bad luck. If only we had arrived at this hangar an hour before the raid. 2 hours would have been better.
It was this air drone the Allied bombers were aiming at?
And hit. They didn't leave one single plane that I can get into the air. Let's walk around the hangar once more.
Oh, what were all these planes?
Mostly German. When they captured Halleville, this was where they kept their Messerschmitt 109s and the Fokkers 190s that needed overhauling.
Why is there nobody here?
They must have made it a secret depot. Can you see the camouflage?
Pierre, look. It's the kitten.
Oh, yeah, fine. But I have other things to think about.
Oh, it's hungry.
Leon, this is no time to be kind to animals. Half of France is also hungry. I want to find an airplane to take me to England so we can have our country back.
Here, kitty, kitty.
Leon, where are you going? You're not taking that cat, will you?
Shoot, God. Now you frightened it. It went under this tarpaulin. Here, kitty, kitty. No, it's crawled way underneath the tarpaulin. Look.
What?
An airplane we didn't see before. Fantastic. A French Morane fighter.
It's been sitting under this canvas for 10 months.
How do you know?
I'll bet you it's never seen service. It's so clean.
Look at its guns. It must have ammunition somewhere aboard, I know.
Right behind here. Huh? You hear that? It's in there. The ship was hidden by the French and never used.
Why not?
We'll give it a test run and see how far we get. I'm going to leave you in charge, Leon.
Why? Where are you going?
I will show you how to fill the tanks with fuel. You see, look here, on top. You unscrew that. Back where we were standing, by that hangar door, are stone steps. Go down those, and you'll find plenty of portable tanks of gasoline. I'll be back when I can.
Where are you going?
I can't go without Yvonne. I have to go back to Paris and persuade her.
But it will take you hours.
But of course you must. The Gestapo will go back to her hotel. It's not safe for her, dear.
Because I hid there?
Who knows who saw you go into that house? And when the Gestapo return and find I, too, have left, they will start investigating. I am known, Leon. Until I broke my leg, I was one of their best pilots. The Gestapo will come looking for us both. Fill the plane with fuel, then hide. Pray that I can persuade Yvonne to come back with me. And tomorrow night, we'll take off.
I was beginning to be very afraid. You've been gone a long time.
I know. Come. Let's pull the canvas from the plane.
But what happened? Where's your friend Yvonne?
I came too late.
Too late?
The hotel was empty. The murderers had come and gone.
Now, I don't understand.
Blood in the hallway, on the steps to the street. Blood running into the curb. Tire marks over the blood. I went next door.
What could they tell me?
No one would answer my knock. 2 o'clock in the morning, I tried another door on that street. Another. Everyone is too frightened to open. Then across the street, I found this old man. I had never seen him before in all these years. He had seen everything from his window. The Nazis had been there. There were shots. It killed Yvonne's mother and father. Yvonne tried to run. They shot her in the back and dragged her into a truck. I came too late. Too late. All we can do now is save ourselves.
A miracle of miracles how you got this plane off the ground in total darkness.
A little experience helps.
I've never flown a plane like this one before.
The Morane fighter is an old friend.
I'm going to try the gun. These are new to me.
I hope you won't have to use them. Somewhere out there is a war going on. I'm glad the guns are operational.
How far is England?
I'll know better when we get further south.
But England is north of France, not south.
Leon, both Belgium and your country, Holland, are occupied. I wouldn't have a chance flying over the airspace. So we're heading for Brittany. And then I'll turn north at 5 degrees to make Land's End in England.
What's that light over there?
Dawn, my friend. I can just about make out some landmarks. Yes, there are the Channel Islands.
Is that close?
We'll go along the coast as far as St. Mathieu, then hopefully north to England.
I haven't seen any Germans yet.
You will.
What's that?
Nothing. I was changing it over to a leaner mixture.
I didn't like that sound.
If you look ahead, you'll see something far more alarming. There's a weather build-up coming this way from England.
That's how the British welcome you. Well, can't we fly over it?
This airplane isn't happy over 30,000, Leon, and neither am I.
No,
we're going to have to fly under.
It's a safe so near the water.
Leon, I once heard the Dutch are apathetic, but knowing you as I do, I say the Dutch have an extraordinary sense of humor. What is safe in wartime? If I fly over the clouds, I am competing for letdown space with British fighters and bombers, also coming home.
But how can you see anything at all?
Oh, no, I can't believe it.
What's happened?
The altimeter has conked out on us. It's not working.
What does that mean?
I'm flying over water, but how far above it, I have no way of knowing. The soup we're going through now gives me no visibility at all.
Oh, no, this can't be the end of the line. I won't accept it.
Pray.
Pray, he said. I'd like to know the last time my prayers were answered.
Leon, if you're not going to pray, be quiet and don't get in the way of my prayers.
I left my house in the middle of the night last night. They were knocking on the doors just down the street. I knew I had to run.
You left your family?
I had no family. Only my mother and father. They're old people. They live in Leiden. I was working in Paris. Have we turned north yet? Pierre, can you hear me?
Yes. I banked to the right 10 minutes ago.
Pray. At midnight, I took the mezuzah from my door. I have it with me to remind me of my faith. But I am losing my faith.
Oh, no.
No.
Hold on to your seat, Leon.
What is it? What's happening? Pierre, say something.
Leon. Leon.
Did somebody call my name?
Are you all right?
I hit my head on something. What happened? Why didn't you answer me?
Didn't you see the English Channel 100 feet below us?
What? Was that the channel?
A split second later and we would have been in the water. I got the stick back just in time. Fuel's running low.
Oh, how low?
I don't know if we've enough to get us to England. From Brest to Land's End is a good 150 kilometers.
And if not?
Try to make Holland or Belgium before we're shot down.
Well, can't we fight back?
We can, and we will. But if we can avoid it, we should. That's why I want to gain as much altitude as possible and try to find a friendly airfield while there's still petrol in our tanks.
There's a plane up there, high above me. Can you see it?
A bandit at 11 o'clock, an unidentified plane. There's another.
Could they be British returning to England after a raid?
I don't know. I can't tell from here.
They're firing at us from the ground.
And we are leaving.
Who played? They disappeared.
No, they haven't. They're flying in and out of clouds tops at about 17,000.
They're German. Messerschmitt 109.
One's lower than the other.
I'm going to come up behind the lower one.
Gunfight.
You German plane! It's coming apart!
We're getting out of here before the other Germans spot us.
Well, you're not going for the other one?
Yes, I am.
Change my mind. Hold on.
Forward, stick back, left rudder.
He doesn't know you're on his tail.
I see him back and on target in my gunfight.
Here goes. You see this? He's smoking!
He's climbing up.
He's going to jump on it. There he goes!
I'm not afraid of this!
What's that noise?
We used up too much fuel in that fight.
Leon, you remember before we took off at Halleville, I showed you how to push back the canopy and climb out of this plane?
You mean me? Do it now?
He isn't going to take us anywhere near England. We're back over Brittany now. Let's jump.
Up here in the sky?
As soon as we come out of this cloud, I'd say one, two, three, and we jump.
Pierre, where are you?
Over here. Where are you? I can't see you.
I landed on top of a haystack, but I'm all tangled up in my parachute.
Stay where you are. I'll help you.
I'm not going anywhere. I couldn't move if I wanted to.
I see you up there. You landed in a good soft spot.
Yeah, well, how do I get out of this?
A little lesson I didn't have time to teach you. But don't move till I tell you.
Right.
If you dislodge that haystack, you've no idea how angry it makes a farmer. Hey, get your arm through here.
Huh? Yeah. Here?
Yes. Now the other arm.
Uh-huh.
Now let me slip this sideways. Unhook. Ah, you're free. Oh. Take my hand. Ease yourself off the stack.
What? Well, now what do we do?
You are going to run for those woods and hide. I can't help you anymore. There's no point in staying with me.
Well, what happened to the airplane after we jumped?
Didn't you hear it come down, Leon? It exploded over there somewhere.
But won't the Germans start looking for us?
If you saw our parachutes, yes.
I'll go now, that way. You know, I'm almost ashamed to tell you this, Pierre.
Hmm?
I've lost my left shoe.
You can have mine.
Oh, no, I refuse to take your only shoe.
Don't be stupid. Take it. Do as I say. You need to run.
I don't.
You're being followed. I am not. You are persecuted. I am not. I'll get to England. I have the one ingredient you don't. Experience. That makes up for everything, including my other leg.
Mm-hmm.
Here. See if you can walk in it.
Hmm.
Put it on, Leon.
All right.
I've something else for you.
Thanks. A map.
Printed on parachute cloth. Now look. This is France.
Mm-hmm.
There's Germany. Belgium.
Yes.
I think we are in this corner of Holland.
If I could get to Leiden, my family is there.
Be careful. It's overrun with Germans protecting the coast from being invaded. What are you standing there for? The shoe fits. Now go.
But how are you going to go anywhere without an airplane?
I didn't have a plane this time yesterday either. All I need is a crutch or a stick.
No, I can't leave you. I feel I owe it to you. What's the use of what I've done if you're picked up now?
Leon, I see a farmer. He's talking toward us. I'll distract him.
Go, Leon.
Heaven, you are Dutch and this is Holland.
Keep moving.
You ought to be able to distinguish between a Dutch patriot and a Nazi.
Pierre, God be with you.
You there! You with the one leg! Stand still! Shoot!
Come now, you wouldn't injure my one and only good leg, would you?
Danger was the everyday occurrence for thousands who fought silently against oppression. Our story is legend today of the ace flyer who, with one leg and a crutch, not only managed to stay alive and help others, but could fly fighter planes. How long and how well he lived this charmed life, I'll pass along when you join me shortly for Act Three. Of the last world war are filled with accounts of prisoners escaping, civilians sabotaging, men and women seeking every means to attack the invader. This handicapped air ace, Pierre Montand, sets an example and fires the imagination. He stands now in Holland, interrogated by the local arm of the Gestapo.
What is your name?
Pierre Montand.
Age?
41.
You are in civilian clothing. Are you a soldier in disguise?
Have you seen any one-legged Frenchman in our armed forces?
If I require sarcasm, I shall request it. Now remember, so far as we are concerned, you are a spy.
I am a civilian who was permitted by decree to leave Paris.
Mm. Parisians were permitted to leave by the southern gate before midnight yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Not fly all the way to Holland.
I was testing a French fighter and ran out of fuel. It was not my intention to parachute into this country.
Well, that I agree with you about. It would be hardly an escape to fly into our arms, hmm? Why have you no papers?
I lost them when I parachuted this morning.
Hmm. So, what were you doing in that airplane?
I took off from Halleville yesterday to test it. My instruments failed, and in the dark, I got lost.
Oh, you really expect us to believe that?
Why shouldn't you? It's the truth.
You flew alone?
I make all the tests alone. Have you found the plane?
Oh, yes. Yes, we have.
Well, then you know it was a French Morin.
And armed. Now, you plan to fight the Reichsmarschall's Air Force single-handedly?
I told you I was testing the plane. My leg does not permit me to fly in combat.
Halleville is in our hands. Now, I find it difficult to comprehend you were ordered to test.
Your major did not find it difficult. He ordered me. That's all there was to it.
Mm. You claim you are French, hmm?
I was born in Lyon.
You are Jewish?
No, I am not.
Well, how can you explain this object?
What object? Where?
I don't touch such things with my hand. In front of you, lying on the desk.
I see it. What is your question?
Please tell me what that is.
I don't know what it is.
Oh, you have no idea, hmm?
Where does it come from?
This is what we wish to know. But tell us, Pierre Montand, what does this small object mean to you?
Nothing. We don't see those in France.
You have too many of these in France. But that is being taken care of. Now, what was this object doing in your airplane?
I have no idea. If it was in the wreckage at all.
The edges of this mezuzah are burned.
It is not mine. Draw your own conclusions.
Oh, we have.
Well, somebody may have left it in the plane before I took it up.
Somebody did leave it in the plane. Your passenger.
I had no passenger.
You will unscrew the top of this mezuzah. Go on, go on, go on. Yes, but inside is a rolled-up piece of paper with printing on it from the scriptures. Now, turn the paper over. Mm-hmm. God help Leon. It's written there. Yes? No. Who is Leon?
I have no idea.
Mm. Tie his hands behind him to the pole. Now, I am getting out of my chair to stand right in front of you and to ask you, who is Leon?
The name means nothing to me.
Oh, you have forgotten. Oh, it does that help you to remember, hmm?
I don't remember because I don't know.
Perhaps if I shake your brains a little, it will jog your memory. Now, who is Leon?
I have no idea. I didn't examine the passenger seat before I took off.
Are you...
I tell you, I don't know any Leon.
And you have any idea perhaps whose left shoe this is also found in the plane?
That shoe? Yes, I do.
Ah, well, now we are beginning to understand one another. And who is it?
Well, that shoe is mine.
It could be possible you are telling the truth. In the absence of papers, we are holding you. What? Oh, yes. Yes, I thought so. One leg only. Yes, one leg. His left leg is good. Yeah, that's the man. French. Yes, Montand. French too, eh? French too. Yes, I took down the description. Yes, I get in touch with our people in Leiden. Lines, I can only apologize. Now, we had no idea this Hans Tuver was famous. Now, don't you worry about Montan. He will talk. We'll see to that. It's his decision.
Talk or lose the other leg. Yes, Hans, I did call you. This place is full of traitors. As Pierre Montan escaped.
I said he escaped. Yes, I know I'm shouting. I always shout when I'm angry. The Frenchman is probably halfway to England by now. Yes, I will. I'll line up all the guards up in the village square and we'll have an execution. No, I don't even have enough men I can trust to do that. I know it's not your worry. Yes, goodbye. Hi, Hitler.
Dr. Whitfield, are they overdue?
I'm afraid so. All the Lancasters returned, but not all the fighter escorts.
When were they due back from the Essen raid?
45 minutes ago.
In 11 months, the squadron leader hasn't lost a man. That gives me hope.
Luftwaffe is getting smarter.
For a flyer with one leg and a crutch, Pierre is a miraculous leader.
There isn't a nurse here at Hillsworth who doesn't have a crush on him, so I can hardly blame you, Julia.
Oh, it isn't that. Maybe it's because he's French, or maybe even because he's disabled. There's a kind of foolhardiness about Pierre, but I can't say it's that either. I think I admire him because he's so disciplined and so careful.
Well, he wouldn't be rotated to squad leader that often if he wasn't. What I've noticed about Martin since he joined the RAF is that he appears driven, like a man fighting his own private war.
He's never spoken about it, but I have a feeling he's lost someone very dear to him. The Spitz are back. What did I tell you? They're coming in. Here comes the first. He's peeling off. There's the second.
The second's in trouble. There's smoke. How many Spitfires have you counted so far, Julia?
I'm trying to keep track.
Is that our phone?
They're coming in so fast, on top of one another.
Whitfield here. Where? Got that. Crash landed. You got him out of the plane. How is he? Is he unconscious? Yes. He'll drive right down. You did the right thing. All we can do now is pray. Yes, we're on our way.
Hello, Nurse Julia.
Hello, Pierre. How do you feel?
I'm not sure.
Hello, Nurse Julia. And I'm not sure. Those are the first six words you said in 12 days. I'm so glad.
Really?
That's seven words.
I remember now. Oh, yes. Coming home from Essen.
Just because you can talk. There's no need to overdo it.
Oh, but I want to talk. It clears my mind.
Then talk very quietly, Pierre. And don't move your head.
I shot up a Messerschmitt 109. And the pieces of his tail cut right through my canopy. My head was... I could hardly see.
And you crash-landed at Folkestone. Dr. Whitfield and I went down to pick you up 10 days ago.
10 days? I've been out?
Dr. Whitfield knows his stuff. It was touch and go. You were in a bad way.
Oh.
How do you feel now?
Oh, Julia, I always feel well when we talk.
Strong enough to meet someone.
A visitor? But why not?
There's someone in the doctor's rec room who's asked to let him know when you were awake. I'll fetch him.
Julia... You will come back, won't you?
You're my patient. Why wouldn't I?
Good. Good. Pierre? Pierre? Huh? What? I must have dozed off.
Do you remember me?
Leon. Leon van Stoel.
Yes. Glad you did no damage to your memory.
Leon, you of all people. How did you find me? What are you doing here at Hadesworth?
Is that what they give visitors to wear? You look like a doctor.
Listen to him. I would say for a man in the condition they found you, you've made a remarkable recovery. Leon, you are a doctor.
How do you find him, Doctor?
Oh, well, better than I would have hoped.
If it wasn't for Dr. Van Stuber, Pierre, I don't know if you'd be here today.
Yeah, I'll tell you something, nurse. If it were not for Pierre Montand, I wouldn't be here today either.
I'm not sure I can follow all this. But I want to know what happened to you, Leon, after we split up in the field in Holland.
Well, I did get to my family in Leiden.
Ah.
And then I heard you'd been arrested in Rotterdam.
Yes, sir.
I went there. And my friends told me you had escaped.
Yes, I did. How did you get out of Holland?
Oh, very slowly and carefully. I ended up in a hospital in London.
I never knew you were a doctor.
Well, 2 weeks ago, I was told a French flyer with one leg returning from a mission had crash-landed. He had a fractured skull, so I got them to fly me here. I knew it was you.
You came to be with me?
I came for a little more than just a reunion. I had a chance to do something for you. To thank you the only way I could for rescuing me from the Gestapo.
Pierre, you didn't understand what I meant about Dr. Van Stuber.
I'm a brain surgeon. The day before yesterday, I operated on you.
Leon,
shall we say a life for a life?
Devotion, friendship, self-sacrifice, and comradeship too quickly nowadays. And I feel it is not out of keeping that from time to time, we at the Mystery Theater should remind you that for every villain, there is a hero. A brotherhood not limited to wartime, but that can occur anytime. I shall return shortly. Requires armies and police for people to live in harmony with one another, in a world of jealousy and greed and anger, where the bywords are, what's in it for me, and I'm taking care of number one, we like to recall these words of St. John's. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. We are happy to report both Leon and Pierre lived to tell this tale. Our cast included Louis Turenne, Roberta Maxwell, and Earl Hammond. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Ravenhouse Paperback Mysteries.
This is E.G. Marshall, inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.